point. Reading, just taking the Civil War for instance, you've got to understand both sides of the issue. And you better go back at least 30 to 40 years. What made it happen? No different than the Japanese bombing Pearl Harbor. What made that happen? They didn't wake up one day and decide to do it. What caused that? Who aggravated them to the point of feeling that they needed to do that? Somebody did.
What brought that on?
Exactly. And what brought that on? Were we stifling them? Did we anger them so much with trade situations?
What are you a member of? You're a member of what?
Civil War Roundtable.
Civil War Roundtable. Where's that at?
Well, they're in every city.
They're in every city.
These are scholars, authors, extremely intelligent people that discuss Civil War battles in all different areas of
what do they do? Reenactments?
Oh, no. They're scholars. They're writers.
Okay.
And it's vastly interesting to hear the opinions of both sides without anybody yelling and screaming or being outlandish about it. And it's history. And when you understand it was a war of attrition, and then you understand about state rights, you understand about slavery, but you have to go way back before. Michelle Lee put it best, if you don't understand the United States now, you have to learn to understand it prior to the Civil War. It's the only way you can understand why we're the way we are now. It makes a whole lot of sense to me since I've been studying and studying. I'm still finding out so many new things. The further away we get away from it, the more
developed. Well, you never stop learning.
No.
And the more you learn, the more you find out how stupid you are. And if you don't learn history, you're what?
Stupid.
Doing to repeat it.
Exactly. Which is, nobody wants to
they're trying to take down these statues here.
Oh, and they are in Louisville.
Yeah.
Now,
how stupid is that? Isn't ISIS doing the same thing?
Oh, yeah. But I think they're bombing them.
Yeah, well, either way, you're removing history, aren't you?
They're hiding history, is the way I look at it. Well, we'll stow it someplace. No. It's there for a reason. I don't particularly like looking at a picture of Muhammad Ali, draft dodger, plastered on the side of a building that I have to drive by on the interstate. I just don't look at it. If I don't like something, I don't look at it. Sticks and stones can hurt my bones, but words can never hurt me. So that's you go with that attitude. I don't like it.
How libertarian of you.
But isn't that the truth? You know, if you say something that's insulting to me, you know, I can either come back with a real good comeback or just let it roll and keep on going.
Now, don't you think we make a good-looking couple? Seriously, shouldn't? I've asked her to marry me 3 times now. I'm going to do it 1 more time on camera. But this is it. I'm going to give her a little time to think about it. What do you think, huh? You marry me.
I'll marry you.
Oh, God, I'm in trouble.
We have witnesses now.
Jesus.